I quit my job to become a full-time freelancer and started making 3 lakhs per month. In this video, I will talk about the different types of projects that I've worked as a freelancer and how you can build your own data portfolio to get a job and get a freelancing gig. So make sure you watch this video from start to end to understand the different types of projects you will get as a data engineering freelancer. So without wasting time, let's get started. The first type of projects that I worked on was about web scraping. Now these are not core data engineering projects, but at the start of my freelancing career, I took whatever the projects that I got and started working on it. These are the top 2 web scraping projects that I really liked working on. In the first project, client had millions of HTML files stored onto the Google Cloud Storage. Google Cloud Storage is basically an object storage where you can store all of the different types of files that you want. What he wanted to do, he wanted to extract different types of data from all of these HTML files and load the tabular data onto the PostgreSQL. The architecture of this project was pretty simple. I had to write the simple Python script to read the data from Google Cloud Storage and load that data onto the PostgreSQL. So it was pretty simple. I had to use the Google Cloud library to access the data from the storage and use the beautiful soup to extract the data from the HTML file and load that data onto the PostgreSQL. Another web scraping project that I worked on was building the COVID data pipeline. So here's the architecture about this particular project. The project was on AWS. Client wanted to extract data from multiple websites that published COVID data, then load that data onto the DynamoDB, which is the NoSQL database service provided by AWS. This project was around near real-time data, so we were extracting all of this data every 5 seconds to 10 seconds and then loading this data onto the DynamoDB. Pretty simple architecture. We extract data, we do some transformation and then load it on DynamoDB so that client can build a dashboard or do whatever he wants to do with that particular data. So these were the top 2 projects that I really liked working on the web scraping side. Second types of projects that I worked on was building ETL pipeline or writing transformation script. Now in these types of projects, you might have to write the transformation code from the scratch or use the existing transformation code and modify the logic based on the requirement provided by the business. So we have a client who uploads the daily data at 9 a.m. on S3. On S3, we can set some kind of event, so whenever the file gets uploaded, we want to run some transformation code. So on this transformation code, we can use AWS Lambda. So whenever any data is uploaded onto S3, we will run our Python transformation code that is deployed on AWS Lambda, the serverless compute service provided by AWS. So once our code executes, we will transform that data and load that data again onto the AWS S3 so that we can use the AWS Athena to directly query on top of the existing files and start getting the insight from it. So again, these were the very basic projects that I worked on at the start of my career when I was involved in modifying the existing scripts or writing the small transformation logic for the client who don't understand how to write the code. The third type of projects that I worked on was about building data lakes and data modeling. These are the core data engineering projects where the client wants to build their entire data infrastructure from getting data to publishing that data onto the data warehouse so that we can run analysis query on top of it. And these projects are pretty long term, so you will be working with multiple teams, try to understand the requirement and then build the entire data infrastructure. So in these type of projects, first we need to understand the client requirement, what type of data they really have in their system, where all of this data is coming from and what we really want at the end of the project. So in most of the projects, I was working with the multiple teams, try to understand what they need. So sometimes you will work with the business team, sometimes you will work with a data analyst and try to understand what they really need, what types of column that they want to get from all of this data and how frequently these pipelines should run. The first step in these type of project is to understand the data and build the data dictionary. Most of the time, companies do not have the proper documentation. So whenever any new person joins the team, he needs to have proper documentation so that they can understand the data and start getting onboarded quickly. After that, we can start building the data lake and write the transformation logic. A data lake is basically the centralized repository where you can store all of these data. So again, in most of the cases, we will get the data from the multiple sources such as RDBMS, APIs, some sensor data, some people might be uploading data manually. We need to make sure all of this data is stored onto one location and then we need to prepare it for the transformation. So here's the basic architecture about the system. If we have data coming from the multiple sources such as RDBMS or APIs, then first we will load all of these data into one storage location. In this case, I was working on AWS, so I was loading all of this data onto S3. Simple storage service. Once we have our data loaded onto S3, then we can build a proper transformation plan. So sometimes data scientists or data analysts directly want to query the data. So we can build AWS Athena tables on top of the file so they can write the SQL query on top of it. So this is the one type of pipeline where you don't have to write any transformation code. People can directly start querying the data on top of the existing file. The second part of this pipeline is about writing the proper transformation logic and then loading our data onto the data warehouse so that we can run some analysis. In the second part of the pipeline, we can use services such as EMR, Elastic MapReduce, or AWS Glue. These are the services where you can write your code in Apache Spark or Python to transform your data into proper structure. Once this is done, we can load our data onto AWS RedShift, that's the data warehouse service provided by AWS, so that machine learning engineers, data analysts, or business people can start building a dashboard and start taking decisions quickly. This was the reason why I included the Spotify Data Pipeline project in my Python for Data Engineering course, because these are the common projects that I worked on in my freelancing career, and this is what you will get when you get into the job or in the real world. So if you are interested in learning how to execute this entire project, then you can check the link in the description and enroll for the Python for Data Engineering course. The fourth type of project that I worked on was about building the real-time data streaming platform. Now, over the years, I've seen apps such as Google Maps or Uber, how they process the real-time data and how we see all of these things in the real-time basis. Once I got the chance to work on the real-time project, that blew my mind completely. I was able to understand the underlying technology behind how these real-time data are getting processed and everything getting delivered to us. Working with the real-time data is a little bit difficult because data continuously flows through the one system, and we need to build a proper system so that we can easily process this data and store these data for the longest period of time. In my freelancing career, I worked on two really good data streaming projects. So in the first project, client had the data coming from the Bitcoin transaction and wanted to build a proper data warehouse on the Google BigQuery so that they can understand all of these transactions and take the important decision. So here's the project architecture. Data was being pushed into the PubSub topic. PubSub is an asynchronous messaging service where we have the producer and a consumer. Producer can push the data and consumer can consume the data and use the data as per their needs. So client used to push the data onto the PubSub topic. It is a service using which we can transform our data in real-time basis. And to process all of this data, we have the framework called as the Apache Beam. You can write your code in simple Python and use Apache Beam to process data and load it onto the target location. In this case, it was picked. Query. The second project was similar to this, but in this case, we had the data coming from the multiple sources such as APIs, RDBMS, manual upload. We were getting all of this data in real-time basis, so we use Apache Kafka to process all of this data and then build a data lake on Google Cloud Storage. So we dumped all of this data onto the storage as it is. Once the data was loaded into the Google Cloud Storage, so it was sent to two places. One for the machine learning service so that we can build a forecasting model, and using Cloud Data Proc, which is used for writing the transformation job in Apache Spark, we transform our data and load that data onto the Google BigQuery so that we can build a dashboard and start doing the analysis. So these are mainly two types of projects that I work in real-time streaming. The two core services or the tools that we use to process the real-time data was Apache Beam or GCP and Apache Kafka. The fifth type of project that I worked on is about data migration. Data migration is basically companies have their data stored onto the on-premises data system. They either want to move to the cloud platform or they want to migrate to the latest technology so that they can optimize the performance and save some cost. There are mainly two types of data migration happens. One is the homogeneous and second is the heterogeneous. So in the homogeneous, you migrate to the existing database only. So in this case, let's say if you have the PostgreSQL server on on-premise center, then we can move the PostgreSQL on cloud. So this is called as a homogeneous. In the heterogeneous, we basically move to the new system such as PostgreSQL to MySQL or RedShift to Google BigQuery. It can be anything. The system is different on the both of the places. To do the data migration, we have multiple approaches. As I was working on AWS, to migrate the data, we have something called as AWS DMS. Data migration service, where you can just connect to the different data sources and start migrating the data. You don't have to do anything else. But in the case of heterogeneous migration, we also have to move stored procedures, SQL script, functions, and all of the other things, because the way we write our SQL script is different on PostgreSQL compared to MySQL. And to migrate all of these objects, we have something called as SCT. Schema conversion tool. So using SCT first, you can migrate all of these objects, and then using DMS, you can migrate all of these data. Now there are multiple ways where you can perform data migration, such as you can write your own Python script if you want to do that, or you can just take the backup of the data from one system and load that data onto the target system. The sixth type of project that I worked on was building dashboard. Now building dashboard does not come under the core data engineering practice. This is generally called as the analytics engineer or a BI reporting guy. But as a freelancer, I got to work on multiple things. So sometimes I chose to build a dashboard because it was fun and I learned a lot of things while building the dashboard. To build a dashboard, the first thing you need to understand what businesses really want. You can't take some random charts and metrics and start putting on a dashboard. You need to talk to the business team and understand what they really want to see. So the business team really means is that, let's say you are working on an e-commerce platform. And in the e-commerce platform, we have multiple components such as order, shipping, return product, and many more things. So a person who is responsible for, let's say, return orders might want to understand why we are getting a lot of returns on particular category or at the particular region. So we can have the proper dashboard in place so that that person can come every morning, look at the dashboard and try to understand, okay, today we got around, let's say 30 returns. Today we got around, let's say 100 returns. Why that happened? So they can look deep into the data and try to understand the root cause of it. This is the most important key skill of building a dashboard. It is not about learning the tool. It is understanding the what businesses really want. So in my case, I mainly use Looker Studio, Power BI and Tableau. You know what the best part is? I have created all of these projects for free on my YouTube channel. So you can click onto all of these cards and start building your own project. This was all for this video. I hope you learned something new. If you have any questions, feel free to comment it out. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.